guys, it's finally Halloween season, and I partnered with Simple Skincare to show you two transformations today. Halloween can be a scary time for your skin, but Simple's products allow me to make up for all my makeup by putting the good ingredients back into my skin, especially when I'm playing around with a kooky look like me. Alright, so without further ado, let's turn into a panda. My skin is already clean and moisturized, but I'm going to add a primer because I want that face paint to be as smooth as possible. I'm using this one by Tarte, but there's a ton of other great drugstore options you can use as well. Now, grabbing NYX's Jojo Eye Pencil and Black Bean, I'm going to start drawing in a circular shape around my eyes. I'm going to take my time with this because I want to be careful and precise as I can. Once you have that circle down, I'm going to draw a little extension on the end because panda eyes tend to have that little droop there. Once that's done, go ahead and replicate that onto the other eye. And once you have two circular shapes, you're going to go off and start coloring it all in. It's totally fine to be messy because we're going to set it down with an eyeshadow anyway. Once you're done coloring, I'm going to grab this black sparkly eyeshadow from Maybelline, and then with the brush, I'm just going to start packing down where we did the eyeliner. This is going to make the black more opaque, and it's going to add a little sparkle. So no complaints here. Once you're done, let's grab that face paint, and then with my fingers, I'm just going to start applying this onto my face. I tried using a brush with this, but I quickly found out that it applies best with your fingers. Now I'm just going to quickly touch up around the eyes so I can just neaten that all up. Alright, let's tackle that nose now. I'm basically just outlining the top of my nose, giving it that cute bear-like nose. Then with the same eyeliner, I'm going to apply it onto my lips because I'm just trying to be resourceful. So I messed up a little on the nose-mouth connector, so I just grabbed a simple facial cleansing wipe and I redid that section so that it's just a clean line instead of that weird triangle thing I did. Ugh, much better. Now I'm just going to finish this off by tightlining using this Revlon Colorstay eyeliner. So just pop on that panda hat and you're ready to roam around like a little bear. This is such an easy and cute costume to rock this year. Who doesn't love pandas? So I'm going to get started onto my second look now, and I'm going to need to take this all off. I'm grabbing Simple's Dual Effect Eye Makeup Remover as my first step, and I'm going to shake that bottle because this is a bi-phase formula. I drenched my cotton round, and then I'm going to gently press it onto my eye. There's no need for harsh rubbing, it just dissolves the makeup while being gentle on the skin and the lashes. Seriously, look at these cotton rounds, they're totally black. Now that both of my eyes are clean, I'm going to go ahead and use Simple's Hydrating Cleansing Oil for the rest of my face, and I'm going to apply it directly onto my dry skin. I'm going to start rubbing it in, and the formula is going to start acting immediately. Add a little bit of water to really get it going, and then rinse with warm water. Now my skin is clean and instantly hydrated, as you can see, so I'm just going to get started onto my second transformation. For foundation, I'm using Maybelline's Fit Me foundation. I'm going to dot this all across my face, and I used a foundation shade a little lighter than my natural skin tone because I wanted that milky, pale porcelain base. Now we're going to set that by using a powder. I'm using this one from NARS, but you can definitely use a translucent powder from the drugstore. Next up, we're going to draw on the brows. I'm using this one from Benefit, and I'm just going to start drawing them in like I normally do. This doesn't have to be too perfect because, believe me, when you have this look on, the last thing people are going to notice are your brows. I'm using NYX's Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, and I'm going to apply that all over the lid. This is going to be your much-needed base. Now I'm going to bust out my trusty Lorac Pro Palette. This guy has definitely seen better days. I'm going to grab white, and then I'm going to pop that on where we applied the white base. Then, using Sable, I'm going to apply it right over the white to give myself a larger crease. Then, with the fluffier brush, I'm going to blend until it looks seamless. To add more dimension, I'm using Espresso, which is a dark brown. I'm going to pop that onto my outer crease just to deepen the eyes, and then we're done. I'm grabbing my Kat Von D tattoo liner, and I'm going to start drawing in a super sharp wing to both eyes. There's nothing subtle about this look. Then I'm going to grab some black eyeshadow, and with a smudge brush, I'm going to give myself a cut crease to make my eyes more doll-like. It might look a little harsh like this, so make sure you give it a good old blend before you move on. Let's widen those eyes even more by using Milk and tightlining the entire lower eye. This is an illusion that's going to make your eyes look like they begin here now. Next up, grab your liquid liner and draw in your new eye shape. Make sure you use a light hand with this, and if it's not perfect, it's okay because we're going to draw in some fake lashes, which are going to hide any imperfections you made. Now feel free to add some mascara, or you can be like me and pop on some falsies, your choice. I'm using e.l.f.'s Warm Bronzer palette, and I'm going to start brushing on some cheekbones. I want to make them really pop. Then I'm going to drag some of that bronzer onto the apples of my cheeks to make them more circular and doll-like. Then to finish off this contour, I'm going to do my nose and make it more narrow. For blush, I'm using this blush quad from e.l.f., and I'm using this bright pink tone on the top left. And I'm going to be very generous with this. Dolls usually have really bright cheeks, so that's what I'm gonna do. I gotta have my glow, so I'm using Becca's Champagne Pop, and I'm gonna dust this all over the tops of my cheeks, and this is gonna give me that plastic sheen. For my lip color, I'm using Poppy Peach, and I'm applying that all over the lips to match my blush. So the makeup is pretty much done, but now it's the moment of truth, the cracked portion. Using the same black liquid liner, I'm going to dive in by drawing in the first crack on my face. The first line is always kind of nerve-wracking, but the trick is just to relax and realize that it looks better when the lines aren't too perfect. When you look at shattered glass, you'll notice that it roots from one focal point. So once you figure out where that is, start making even smaller lines that connect to the larger ones. Definitely have a photo of some cracked glass, or feel free to use this tutorial to have on hand if you need any extra help placing the cracks. Next, I'm just going to start shading some of the lines to make it pop and give it more definition. Alright, I'm going to grab this white eyeliner from Too Faced, and I'm going to outline some of the cracks only on one side. This is going to make the entire look pop and make it look even more 3D. You don't have to be too meticulous with this because this is just an optical illusion, and it's going to look best from far away anyway. Once you're done, this is what you should look like: cracked, shattered, and totally awesome. Alright guys, so that was my take on two Halloween looks. I decided to give you one cute one and one creepy one just to give you some variety. I love October because this is the month where you can truly express yourself in whatever shape or form that you want. And I'm so happy that Simple Skincare allows me to make up for all this makeup that I apply on my face, especially this time of year. If you'd like to try out Simple's products for yourself, please head on over to their website. I'll include a coupon in the description box, so make sure you open that. I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye! Yeah.